On a spring afternoon, Cody Corin and Calvin Lamont are out to do some fishing.
What color you need?
Watermelon red.
May switch up here in a second.
Serious anglers like Calvin and Cody work every angle to hook a nice fish.
I got one.
He ain't very big.
Nope, came off.
Otherwise, they might not hear the end of it.
Oh, you didn't even get him in a boat, huh?
We fished together quite a bit.
Come on to daddy. Oh, you little flipper.
That's part of fishing with Cody.
Oh, man, it's a monster.
Pretty normal for us to rib each other.
Little dude.
That's huge.
But these veterans know the key to a respectable fishing trip is finding the right location.
I think when you go hit them ones, see what they got to offer.
That group that's on that point over there.
We'll go to this one for now.
And they happen to know some promising new spots to fish because of a project they helped with more than a year earlier.
Watch your head.
To the uninitiated, that project might not have looked like anything that would improve fishing.
It's got enough tentacles hanging out.
Somebody that doesn't really know would think that we're just piecing recycled garbage together, and we're really not.
So there's gonna be 24 arms for each bait.
We need three more. We're not dumping garbage in the lake. We're actually providing good habitat for these fish.
We are at Lake Cypress Springs to construct some artificial fish habitat structures. There's not a lot of structure for fish like largemouth bass or sunfish to relate to underneath the water. And fish need habitat structure in general. Even in reservoirs that left timber standing, over time that timber in the water breaks down and the habitat for fish declines. So we're at a point where we really need to start doing something with these reservoirs to improve fish habitat. That looks good. We've done work with Christmas trees in the past, but the PVC that we're using in these structures that we're building today are going to last for many, many years. I think these attractors will start working pretty much right away. As soon as the algae can start growing on them, they're going to start attracting fish.
We're out.
And really make that angling experience that much better. Today, the materials have been purchased with money from the Conservation License Plate Program. We're partnering with the Franklin County Water District here.
We need three.
We've got a couple members of a new Bass Unlimited chapter here to volunteer and help make fishing better in Lake Cypress Springs.
Yeah, we love fishing tournaments, but we both understand that without conservation of the lakes, we're not gonna be able to do that. So it's on our part to make sure that we help take care of that, take care of the resource that provides our recreation.
Of course, artificial structures are just one way to help fish.
Check out this little buddy right here. This is flat stem spike rush, water star grass, wild celery, white water lily, square stem spike rush.
Native aquatic plants provide natural habitat.
The more different species that we've got in that plant community, the more stable that plant community is.
The man behind the old-timey mustache is Rick Ott.
People tell me I look like Wild Bill Hickok. And if it makes people smile, I'm all for it. Weeding my garden.
Rick manages a native aquatic plant nursery at the Texas Freshwater Fishery Center in Athens.
It's not just the structure, it's also the actual food that's being produced here. Structural habitat's very important because the fish use it as a place to hide, but the vegetation is producing food that invertebrates consume. Small fish consume the invertebrates, bigger fish eat the smaller fish, and then we eat the bigger fish. That same basis to the food chain is occurring on those plastic structures as we have with the plants. We're just growing a little teeny tiny garden on the surface of that plastic. Here, we've just got a bigger garden with a bigger type plant.
But getting that big garden started is the tough part.
Let's go look at those pondweed cages.
On the water, Rick and his crew check on past efforts.
We're at Burtis Creek State Park. We're coming back to evaluate some of the native aquatic plant plantings that we've done years ago.
We would prefer that it was full of plants.
They find some failure and some success.
I'm liking this a little bit better.
While cages can protect the plants from being eaten, they cannot protect against drought or high muddy water.
We just don't have optimal conditions for plant growth right now. With the water being so turbid, there's not as much sunlight getting to the bottom.
The crew can only hope conditions will improve and replant.
It's kind of comfortable in the summer.
You got it there?
Yep. My mom used to tell me not to get all wet and muddy, but now I can't.
Synchronized swimming, definitely. We had our Esther Williams can going underwater and putting those plants in a little deeper water than we typically plant.
Ken is our deep water guy. A lot of times all we see of Ken is the bottoms of his feet. We know he's working if we can see the bottoms of his feet.
If we get a little bit of luck involving the kind of weather conditions that we have this summer, we should see good survival of the plants that we've put in today.
Nearby, Lake Athens demonstrates what these desirable plants can look like when well established.
We've got a very diverse native plant community here. We've got extensive coverage of a number of species. So ultimately, this is what we're trying to produce. We're getting more and more of these Friends of Reservoirs groups all over the state, allowing us to fund these projects in a number of different places.
It's the key to having a great fishery, you know.
After their workday is done, the crew's intern, Tyreek Landry,
there's one on there,
shows what native plants can do for fishing.
That's a good fish, guys.
You see what it produces. Beautiful fish. Go ahead and turn this guy back. It made my day.
Whether with native plants or strange-looking artificial structures, improving fish habitat makes for a better day fishing.
Here we go. There they are, Sam.
Back on Lake Cypress Springs, Cody and Calvin find some fish at home, near habitats they helped install.
Got it.
Everybody likes a home to stay in. If you got extra places that you can fish that you know is holding fish, that's always advantageous when you're fishing.
If you start catching fish, that's always a bonus. There's a good fish.
Glad you finally caught one.
Some inside information improves the odds in the fisherman's favor.
And these secret spots are really no secret.
Most anglers probably don't know. They can go on the Texas Parks and Wildlife website and get those grid coordinates for the habitats that we've placed.
You could do the same thing with a cell phone. Absolutely. You punch those grids in, and it'll take you right to it as long as you got cell phone service.
Get the net. Oh, we ain't got one.
Look out. There's enough habitats in here that the fish are gonna be on one of them.
No, it is a crappie. It's a white perch. Hey.
So these habitats are holding crappie.
Caught some crappie and caught quite a few largemouth today.
Great day on the water.
It was a good time.
This project was funded in part by a grant from the Sport Fish Restoration Program